collection and arrangement of data. Hey kids! In this video, we will learn about the collection and arrangement of data. Come, let's take you to the jungle, where the wise owl is waiting for some animals. Every day, they learn some new things from the wise owl. Oh, here you come. How did you all get so late today?
Chiku was playing, Bhalu was trying to steal honey, and Saloni was sleeping.
And Chichi was studying.
Okay, let's learn something new today. Do you want to play a game?
Yes, yes.
So kids, here is a dice.
Now all of you will roll the dice 5 times. We will write down the numbers you get on rolling the die.
Okay.
I will roll first. 1, 4, 6, 2, 2.
So, Chiku got these numbers on the dice. Now, Bhalu, it's your turn.
Okay. 2, 4, 5, 5, 4.
So, Bhalu got these numbers on the dice. Now, Chichi and Saloni, turn-wise roll the dice and see what numbers you get.
1, 1, 3, 4, 6. 5, 4, 5, 6, 6.
So Chichi and Saloni got these numbers on the dice. Now we have made a list of the numbers that you all got by rolling the dice. So children, I can say, in this way, I have collected all the points you got by rolling the dice. This kind of information is also known as data. So I can also say, I have collected the information about the points you got by rolling the dice.
Okay.
Can you give one more example of data?
Yes, of course. See, if I want to know how many members are there in your family, I can make a list by asking you all the number of members present in each one of your family. For example, look at this list. By looking at this list, we can easily find out whose family has the most members and whose family has the least. But if we closely look at this data, can you tell which number hit the dice most of the times? What happened? Why are you taking so much time?
Because we have to first check how many times each number has hit the die.
Perfect. And for this, we can arrange and write our data in this way. Like, we got 1 for 3 times, we also got 2 for 3 times. And like this, we can write 4 different numbers.
Oh wow! You have made a different set for all the numbers.
Perfect! First of all, we made a collection of all the numbers. And did you notice how I have arranged all the numbers from 1 to 6 in a way that makes easy to gather the information? Now tell me, which number came for the highest times and which one for the least?
4 came for the highest times, that is 5 times, and 3 came for the least, only once.
Absolutely right. So kids, in this video, we have learnt about the collection and arrangement of data. Arrangement of data. Hey kids, in this video we will learn about the collection and arrangement of data with the help of examples.
Sister,
oh, what happened today? You all came together?
There is a fair in the neighboring village. Will you take us there?
Definitely, if you promise me one thing.
What promise, sister?
That you all will hold each other's hand so that nobody gets lost.
Yes, sister. We will not leave each other's hand.
Okay, so let's get ready to go to the fair. But before going there, I'll ask some questions. Answer me by raising your hands.
Okay, sister.
So first of all, let's find out the choice of your swings and games, so that it makes easy for us to buy tickets tomorrow. So tell me, who wants to take a ride on the giant wheel? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6.
Sister, I get scared.
It's okay, you can enjoy other rides. Now tell me, who wants to take ride on roundabout? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Wow!
I feel dizziness on it.
It's okay, you can enjoy some other games. Now tell me, who wants to play Pop the Balloon? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Oh wow, everyone would like to play this game.
Yes, sister, one gets prize on winning this game.
Now tell me, who wants to play and win with Throw the Rings? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8.
Sis, what have you made?
I have prepared a list of table according to your wishes. This will help me to know how many tickets I have to buy for each game. Can you tell how many total tickets we have to buy?
35.
Can you tell which game needs the most number of tickets?
Pop the Balloon.
Right, now tell me, for how many games I have to buy more than 8 tickets?
2.
Absolutely correct. So, did you see, when I collected the data and arranged it into a tabular form, how easily you have given answers to my questions?
Yes, sister. Sister, let's discuss one more example based on data collection and arrangement.
Yes, right. We'll also get late while playing there. So, let's collect some data related to foods. So now tell me, who all wants to enjoy Golgappe? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Who all wants to eat cotton candy? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Sister, I have cavities, so I can't eat sweet things.
Okay, who all wants to eat samosas? 1, 2, and 3. Who all wants to eat bread pakoras? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Who all wants to eat ice cream? 1,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8.
Sister, what have you made?
Look, this is known as pictograph. In this, with the help of pictures, I have shown the number of kids with the choices of food. By closely looking at this pictograph, tell me which food is highly chosen by the kids.
Ice cream.
Absolutely right. Now tell me, what should we buy more? Samosas or bread pakoras?
Bread pakora.
Right. Now tell me, how many kids love golgappas?
7.
Very good. So kids, pictograph is also a very good way to represent data in an organized manner. Have you seen how easily and fastly we have answered with the help of these?
Yes, sister.
Now all of you should go home. We'll meet tomorrow at 11 to go to the fair. So kids, today we have learnt about collecting and arranging data in a tabular form or a pictograph.
Kids, in this video, we have learnt about the collection and arrangement of data with the help of examples. Related to collection and arrangement of data. Hey kids, in the previous video, you have learnt about the collection and arrangement of data in tabular and pictographic form. In this video, we will learn about some common misconceptions related to collection and arrangement of data. We often make mistakes in the collection of data. For example, look at these numbers and tell how many numbers are greater than 2 and the number of times they have appeared. We usually get confused, should we count in 2 or not? Let's look at this example. Some kitchen items and their numbers are shown here in a tabular form. Which items are more than 6 in numbers?
Spoon and glass.
Is it the right answer?
I think just the glass, because you asked more than 6. Therefore, we cannot consider 6.
Absolutely right. While counting more than a particular number, the number itself is not considered. But Saloni, if I would have asked which kitchen item is more than or equal to 6, then your answer would be correct.
Oh, now I get it.
So now can you tell me, which kitchen item is less than 6 in number?
Knife and bowl.
Absolutely right. While counting less than a particular number, the number itself is not considered. Similarly, if we look at the numbers of items which are either 6 or less than 6 in the tabular form, we will get knife, bowl, and spoons. So now your confusion must have been cleared. While counting more or less than a particular number, the number itself is not considered. Sometimes it has also been seen that while looking for answers from the pictograph, children do not pay attention to the key given on it. In this pictograph, we are showing a relation between the children's books and the number of kids who like them. By looking at the pictograph, can you tell me How many kids love fairy tales? 5.
Let me say 10.
Chi-Chi has rightly answered this question. Often, we only count the number of pictures, but forget to notice the list given with it. Here, each stick man depicts 2 children. So 5 pictures will depict 10 children. So by making such lists, we can easily show data with less pictures in the pictograph. Now again, take a look at the pictograph.
Who will tell me how many kids love horror books?
But here we have only half a stick man.
Right. If a whole stick man means 2 children, then half the stick man will mean
1 child.
Right. So how many children love horror books?
3.
Absolutely right. So kids, in this video, we have learnt about some common misconceptions related to collection and arrangement of data. Chart, strip chart. Today we will learn about what is strip chart, how to obtain information from it.
Brother, what are you doing?
I am arranging my books.
Should I help you?
Yes, of course. Oh, not like this. I am arranging books according to their height. Thank you. Look, have you ever seen a picture like this?
Yes, we have been taught about this at school. Bro, please teach us too.
Okay, look closely at these books. Can you tell me which book is the tallest out of them?
The red one.
Right. And the smallest one?
The yellow one.
Right. Do some books have same height?
Yes, blue and green ones have the same height.
Absolutely correct. So today, I will tell you about strip charts. Today we have learnt what is strip chart and how to obtain information from it. Strip chart. Today we will learn about how to make a strip chart, how to obtain information from it. Come. Today I will measure your hands with the help of paper tape. You all have to write your name on it and put it on this chart. In this chart, all your strips are placed with your name and a scale is drawn towards the bottom. By closely looking at this, can anyone tell me who has the longest hands?
Rahul and Vipan.
How long?
14 centimeter.
Absolutely right. Can anyone identify the hands which is less than 11 centimeter in length?
Satish and Harish.
Yes, absolutely right.
My hand is the smallest of all.
Brother, let's make some more strip charts.
Sure. Look at these strips. Can you guess and identify the animal having this length of legs? You all can put animal sticker on the right strip.
Brother, let me do first.
Yes, very good.
This one is of elephant.
Very good.
And this one is of duck.
Great.
This is of roar, tigers.
So have you all understood strip chart properly?
Yes, brother.
Brother, what are you making for so long?
I have made a big chart for you.
What will we do with this?
Now all of you have to measure a strand of your hair and tell me the length. Vipin, tell me, what is the length of your hair strand?
4 centimeter.
And yours, Hari?
3 centimeters.
So, who has the lengthiest hair?
Mine.
How long is your hair from Hari's?
1 centimeter. Vipin, go get a nice haircut.
Today, we have learnt about how to make a strip chart and how to obtain information from it. Strip chart. In this video, we will learn about some common misconceptions related to strip charts. It is often seen that children usually ignore important data given in table and place strips in any order. This makes the interpretation of data incorrect. For example, look at this data. Here are the marks scored by 3 students in maths. Radha got 72, Krishna got 53, and Madhav got 65. Come, let's represent this in strips. If we place the strips like this, is it right? You can see that according to the chart, Radha got 65 and Madhav got 72. This is very unfair with Radha. We cannot show wrong data like this. Now see, this smart chart is perfect because it is showing correct marks scored by students. So kids, while representing data with the help of strip charts, we should make sure that the strip is conveying the right information. Sometimes, we also have this confusion whether we can place strips only in the ascending or descending order. But kids, we can place strips in any order. We only need to keep in mind that the strip represents the right value. Look at these 3 charts carefully. Kids, you can pause the video and closely look at the chart. You can rightly interpret data from these 3 charts. So, we can say strips can be placed in any order, not only in the ascending and descending one. Some people also believe that changing the axis of the chart gives wrong interpretation of data. Look at both these charts carefully. We have only changed the coordinate axis, but still, we are getting the same information from the data. Who has got the highest marks? Difference between the highest and lowest marks, etc. So, we can say that changing the axis of the chart doesn't change the interpretation of data in it. So kids, in this video, we have learned about some common misconceptions related to strip charts. Smart chart, pie chart. Today we will learn about pie chart. Good morning, kids. How are you all?
We are good.
Doctor Uncle, what is this on the walls of your room?
Through these charts, we get an idea which disease has caused trouble to most kids of our school in this month.
How?
Okay, let me explain. This month, fever, cold and indigestion has caused a lot of trouble to you children. I have represented the data in this form.
Yes, yes, this is called a table.
Absolutely right. Now look at this data in another form.
I will tell. This is pictograph.
Very good. Can you tell me which chart is this?
Yes, this is strip chart.
Very good. Kids, you all know about various types of charts. Do you know about pie chart?
No, Dr. Uncle.
So the chart you are seeing on this wall is known as pie chart. Come, let's learn about this. Today we have learnt what is pie chart. Examples of pie chart. Today you will learn about what is a pie chart and how to find data from a pie chart. So kids, this round-shaped chart you are looking at is known as pie chart.
Is it because it is round like a pie?
Yes. Can you tell what is this chart representing?
This chart represents which disease has troubled most of the kids.
Very good. As you can see in the chart, number of children who got sick due to cold are represented by red color. Number of children who got sick due to fever are represented by blue. And the number of children who got sick due to indigestion are represented by green color.
Doctor Uncle, most of the children had cold.
Right. And the least number of students were affected by which disease?
Indigestion. Yesterday only, I got sick due to indigestion.
Oh, are you okay now?
Yes.
Come, let's look at some more examples. This is a prayer plate. In this, flowers and fruits are kept in this way. If the priest offers all the flowers to the god, how much part of the plate will remain empty?
Half.
Absolutely correct. And if this much fruit is given in the prasad, then how much full will the plate remain?
1/4 fruits remain.
Very good. Now let's look upon more examples. This pie chart shows how many students came to class today. If total strength of the class is 20, then how many students are absent today?
These are the present kids and these are the absent kids.
Here we'll find out 1/4 of 20 because absent kids are 1/4 of the total chart. So 1/4 of 20 will be half of 20 is 10 and half of 10 is 5. So total 5 students are absent today.
Very good. Now let's look at one more example. Now all of you, look at this chart and think if there are half boys and half girls in a class and the number of boys is 10, then what will be the number of girls?
10.
Right. So what is the total number of students in the class?
10 and 10, it's 20.
Very good. So kids, today you have learnt about
What is a pie chart? And how to find data from a pie chart? Smart chart, pie chart. In this video, we will know about some common misconceptions related to pie chart. Sometimes, we consider 1/4 and 3/4 to be equal while calculating. Is this a right belief? First, tell me which is more, 1/4 of potatoes or 3/4 of potatoes?
3/4.
Right answer. Kids, do you know we can write quarter as 1/4 too?
Yes, Dr. Uncle.
So, now can you tell me how to write 3/4?
3/4, is it right?
Absolutely right. Now, look at this 4 same sized wood logs. Now, can you guess their different numbers in relation to this 4 woods?
This is 1/4.
This is 3/4.
This is 2/4.
This is also known as half.
Is this 4/4?
Yes, this means full. Now you must have understood that 1/4 is 1/4. 3/4 is 3/4. Yes, right. Now let's look at some more examples to clear this misconception. Father of Bimla and Chandu has bought a packet of candy. It contains 40 candies. Now look at this pie chart to find out how many candies have been eaten by the kids.
They ate 1/4, that is 1/4 of the candies. So, 1/4 of 40 is 10. So, children ate 10 candies.
So, how many candies are left?
3/4, that is 30 candies.
Very good. Today, while coming to school, students got drenched in rain. Now, can you tell, has more than half of the students got drenched by the rain?
Yes, more than half of the students got drenched in the rain, as 3/4 students got drenched.
Very good. So, I am hoping now your doubt has been cleared regarding the misconception of 1/4 and 3/4 being equal.